All right, lucky for John, I am a circlip hoarder. And I got new circlips. Now somebody... who will remain nameless sent me some old circlips, or used ones. Maybe only used once, but generally that's all they're used is once. And we don't want to be using no old circlippies on here. So I'm gonna, am I on film? Yeah, this'll be fun, right? Trying to get this on film. Always a challenge. Although, you know, I found the ones with the, this is like a G one. G-shaped circlip. I found the ones with the extra tail. On the DR kit, those were cake to put in. See if we can get this one in. It's not cooperating. There it goes, the first drop. All right, I'm gonna do this off camera. Okay, one's in. Can you dig it? Can you see it? Maybe, maybe not. Work that around. She doesn't want to move, does she? Ideally, I want to back. All right, let's try the other way. There it goes. And you just want to make double check, make sure it's all in the groove. Okay, we got the arrow pointing down. Probably get some oil on this wrist pin. We put the small end bearing in already. Arrow down. We'll start it. I'm trying to go in the wrong side. Well, there's a circlip there blocking my path. Let's try this. All right, we're in. Now, the beauty of chopsticks is you can... wood will not scratch metal. So you poke that in with the chopstick, not with the screwdriver. All right, other circlip. It's going to happen off camera as well. Okay, again, I employed the chopstick to push the tail end of that circlip in and get it in the groove. So, hey man, chopsticks are where it's at, and no scratchy scratches, just goody goodness. All right, Mr. John gave us El Gasquetos, which I've put somewhere else. Let me find them. We'll move on to the next step. All right, so we got the base gasket ready to go, kind of. You know what? Let me put this on the bottom on the cylinder already. All right, there we go. So we'll just double check and make sure our, is it on the bottom, really? What? Can't be right. Oh. Okay, our ring moved. Is that it?
There it is.
I was going to say, that thing ain't on the very bottom, is it? No. That wouldn't make any sense, because it would be... Are we live? Are we recording, I mean? Okay. Oh shit, we don't have any studs. He took the studs out. I forgot about that. Alright. Alright, bro. Did I end up buying, And the thing is, with that head, let's back this up a tad. How do you like that? How do you like them apples? Yeah, you thought you had me in a bind. All right, well, we can... can deal with this, I guess. Would have been ideal to have put them on first, but I wasn't thinking, bro. It's all right. No worries. Get out the thread locker red. Try it out. See what we can do here. Why don't you take out all the studs, bro, just for shipping purposes? Of course, right? It's not going to go easy for me. Leaking thread locker red into the... What the hell is that? We lost our cap. Okie dokie, do I have... I do. Hang on a minute. Get to organize. Okay, I've made an executive decision to change things up a little bit. We are going to go with some bolts instead of studs. Because number one, these studs are too long. And number two, these studs are too long. So we're gonna need, let's get that head. Where did you go? There it is. And head gasket. Let's see here. goes like that. Or is this the O-ring? Sweet. Was there a head gasket I saw? Alright, dude, you've got the O-ring. You don't need a head gasket. Oh, it's a little worse for wear. That might have been a problem, too. You've got the O-ring, and you've also got a head gasket here. It's one or the other. How are we going to do this? Alright, we're gonna need our. Oh, it's right here. Come on. Yeah, nothing's cooperating here. Where's that stud? Yeah, these are a bit shorter. How are we looking on camera? So yeah, we need a bit shorter. Going on. We got these things started right. This one's not going in yet. There it goes. Alright, let's see if these are short enough. Need even shorter studs. Damn. get spacers. What to do? Decisions. Let's clean up some of this mess and think about things here. Do they have much shorter than that? Paper towels everywhere. Shit. Yeah, I can't go any further than that. These are have to take it all off and put the studs in. Is that what it's come down to? Oh man. I guess I could Dremel off. Talking how far? What do I have? So, all right, we got some thinking to do here. Here you go, some custom bolt fabrication, at least bolt size. We're gonna make these suckers work. How do you like that? All right, we're getting closer. Now we're talking, bro. Now we're talking. All right, let's get out the torque wrench. Okay, so I noticed the O-ring. If you were using a head gasket and an O-ring, you didn't want to do that. It's one or the other. And the O-ring's a little beat up. It's not terrible, but it's not great. Let's pop a sparky in there, right? Dude, I got boxes and stuff everywhere here. I'm trying to get these empty boxes out of my life. There they are. So fits on there nice. And, you know, these carb bolts do seem to work pretty well. So, you know, I talk a big game. So let's see here, I think red, I've got these spark plug index washers, because we got to add a couple to make this thing. Red's the thickest, and then they tell us, let me see here, blues next, then gold, then silver. So I'm going to throw a red and a silver in addition to the washer that's on there. Gap looks pretty good. King Kong it, you know. Heard that before, haven't you? Haven't you, bro? So, let me think here. Dude, that has got a world of compression. Jesus. Ho, 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 ho. So, well, let's just see here. We got that set on. That's pretty cool. You can do this by hand. And is the carb in the picture? A little bit. So, put it about right there. Oh, that, oh. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna wait on that stator. I'm gonna just take one out of my Townie and stick it in here. Oh, we got to tap that thread. So, Might as well take a look at that now. And that's that is nice. I might want to put some tools away, I don't know, or let me take a look here. But anyways, you know, you really just, the problem with doing this stuff is by the way, here's the piston from my I meant to show this from this the DR kit Urban Express. This was the old piston before I put the DR kit on. Yeah, what do you think? Can we say blow by? Yeah, I think it's done. Trying to run that thing, no wonder, man, I couldn't get the jetting right. So what am I thinking? Oh, we're gonna try to tap this. So I bought Hardware store has the exact stator screw. Beautimus. Yeah, I think this thing is ready to fire without a stator. We don't need no stinking spark. We got compression out the ass, bro. Holy cow, that is mean. So, tap and die set. I guess that's our next move. Tap and die set. See if we can fix that. All right, let me pull that out. All right, bro, I'm kind of tired. That, I don't know what went on here in Statterland. How do you like them apples, huh? Yeah. That was a mess. That was a complete mess, bro. I saved your ass. Saved your ass on that one, man. Holy cow. Okay. Yeah. That was a complete mess. All right, I'm done for the night. So tomorrow we get the stator in, exhaust on, stick a frame on it. Am I missing anything here? Oil in the transmission case. And start it up. Maybe, right? We'll see what happens. But Oh, wow, bro. Okay. We're wrapping this up.